Good morning, class. Today we'll be talking about Pokimane. This dude's been getting on my nerves recently, and I thought I could just make a 4-minute video talking about her recent controversy, but I kind of want to talk about why I don't like her overall. She's a dumb poopy head, and I hate her. Now, just like my other long videos where I talk about one person or one crappy family vlogging channel, I'll be dividing this video into multiple sections in order to elaborate on specifics. So with that in mind, let's start the first section. Pookie Menstrual Cramps' content is very similar to Sniper Wolf's and Azulan's. All three of them are aware that because they are attractive enough, they don't really need to try. I mean, holy shit, I put more effort into my content than they do. And I only use iMovie as my editing software. Much like commentators, she will use other content to make her own content, but the problem is she doesn't add anything new to the other content. It's just essentially her looking cute in front of the camera. I tuned into one of her streams, and the first 20 minutes is just her trying to adjust the quality of the live stream.
I really like the other camera, and I don't know why it keeps overheating, go boom.
Stop!
I still feel like it's really, really sharp.
And then out of nowhere, it just ends after she gives up. I just don't see how fiddling with a camera for 20 minutes is considered content. Her reaction videos, I shit you not, are just as bad. Actually, now that I think about it, her fiddling with a camera provides more entertainment than her sexy kawaii reactions. Because at least I'm not fucking cringing. Alright, let's take a look at this video.
Let's get into it. Imagine filming a Fortnite season reaction video and the police comes into your house.
I don't get the joke. Is this like a common thing in her videos? The police interrupt her or something? I went back to her old videos and I didn't see anything related to that. Or maybe the police actually did come and she didn't explain why. Wait a minute, how long is this video? Oh, now it makes sense. Gotta eat up that time somehow.
So cute. Not gonna lie, Catman has grown on me. Okay, pop off, queen. Flex it. Aw, I really like Hot Dog Man because I'm kind of hungry. Wait, are they gonna let us do stuff like this? There's no way they would show this for this long without letting us do it, right?
I haven't laughed yet, and I don't see how this is transformative content. I don't know, maybe the video picks up later on.
Oh, baby. Oh my god, give me a battle pass you can design? New Trekkies. I like that. The freaking Thor vibes. I know he's like Aquaman and Thor isn't like watery, but you see it, right?
The only thing I see is a video. I have no idea how people watch this and they're like, you know, I'm very entertained right now. This is good content right here. It's just her making cute noises and telling you exactly what's happening in the video. The only opinions she gives out are what she thinks of the new skins. Who gives a shit? I know other people make this type of content, but they at least add comedy to it. There are two reasons why people watch gaming videos. The first reason being the player is very skillful, which automatically counts as entertainment, and Pookie Menstrual Cramps isn't really skillful at this game.
Dude, how come? What?
And the second reason is for comedic purposes. Unfortunately, Pokimane doesn't suck enough for us to laugh about how bad she is, and she's also just straight up unfunny. The only entertainment I receive from a Pokimane video is from the comment section. It really is hilarious how desperate some people can be.
She looks like someone, but I can't quite put my finger on who.
Teehee, I'm so quirky, ooh, my pants,
Ooh, it's giving me Game of Thrones vibes, that's what it is.
Literally, no one from the show looks like that. This just seems like a poor attempt of you trying to convince your fanbase you're into nerdy shit. You know, because I'm not like the other girls.
What if I got into a game, and because I'm a cat, I just meowed?
It probably wouldn't be funny. It wouldn't entertain me. It would make me cringe.
Meow, 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 meow.
I'm gonna have to assume people who enjoy this type of content are the only ones who get off on it. Because I can't see people laughing at some girl making cat noises. I can't see people jerking off to it. So I have to assume that's why she's doing this. It's to keep up her cute uwu persona she has going on. She wants to appear all cute and innocent in front of the camera, and if you attack her for acting this way, people are like, oh, well, she's just having fun. She's just being herself. Yeah, no, this is definitely a fake-ass persona. She portrays herself as a cute bubbly girl so no one can talk shit about her content. Because she's just so innocent. Well, not really. Exactly. Pokimane is a massive hypocrite. A YouTuber named Bo Blacks made a video talking about the Twitter drama between Keemstar and Pokimane. It involved Keemstar insulting one of her fans or whatever. It doesn't matter. What does matter is that Pokimane wants people to think she's drama-free, so she did the rational thing and issued a copyright claim on Bo Blacks' video, which is a real shitty thing to do, but what really bugs me about the situation is that she had this to say.
Edit videos and actually put effort into it and make it more entertaining for the viewer. Like if you do a bunch of Fortnite streamers react to something and you
time like to find put it together popular clips and trending clips and then like edit it.
Wow, I'm so sorry that it takes you a lot of time to steal other people's content. I'm so sorry.
Oh my god, no.
And put it together. I'm so sorry that it takes you so much time to go to the top clips on Fortnite and then just right click and save all of them as and then just like put them all into Premiere and then just like export it. I'm so sorry.
Majority of her content are lazy reaction videos with zero f***ing effort.
Okay. That was epic. That's what I should say at the end of this video. Aww! I didn't know he was gonna hit me with the fuse!
She did later on apologize. Well, not being very subtle trying to gain sympathy, but it doesn't really matter. All this does is really display what type of person she really is. She's not some dumb, bubbly girl whose content may be trash, but she's just too innocent for us to talk shit about it. She's really just a schemer. People are too focused on how attractive she is to notice how bad her content is. And she helps enforce this image by portraying herself as the dumb, bubbly girl. Pokimane straight up has zero personality. She's more bland than my fucking voice. People watch her because she's attractive. She knows it and she plays that shit up. And listen, I don't have a problem with someone simply being attractive in order to gain views and money, but at least be honest about it. Pookie Midget thinks that she has all these followers because she's entertaining. You're an attractive girl playing video games and you don't make people laugh. Gee, I wonder why people watch you. Now, I will give Pokimane some credit. She doesn't really go out of her way to make herself look attractive as hard as most Twitch thoughts. Unlike Alinity, she's attractive enough for her to gain followers by simply wearing normal clothes. But despite all this, she still posts pictures of herself that are supposed to be quote unquote ugly. Here are some no makeup selfies, but from regular slash cute angles and with natural lighting. No one looks good 24/7, and a lot of different things can affect someone's appearance. We're all only human, so let's be kind to one another. I think my favorite part of that whole tweet is her stating that no one looks good 24/7, but she still appears attractive in these pictures.
Dear internet, I am so ugly. This picture is the most disgusting thing you will ever see.
Many people do this to appear humble and down to earth, but in reality they're materialistic and egocentric. Wow, Pokimane, you're so ugly. Yeah, clearly you don't look attractive 24/7. This is definitely you at your worst. Yeah, I'm real sure zero girls felt insecure after looking at your tweet. If this is how you display yourself at your worst, then imagine what Behemoth Betty feels like.
Oh my god, you said the N-word.
Everybody type in the chat, Alex is a stupid nigga.
Oh tee hee haha, I didn't say that, I said this, Nivea. Stop baiting people and spreading lies, I would never.
Haps, my ninja!
Nigga, you ain't funny.
Recently, Pokimane made some pretty idiotic tweets. In this industry, a girl fucks up? What a fake bitch. Such a worthless piece of shit. Also, go die in a hole. A guy fucks up? OMG King, don't worry, everyone makes mistakes. We know you have a good heart and we will be here for you forever. Not only is this not true in any shape or form, but the fact that she's complaining about her position in any way just shows how much of an entitled brat she is. If Twitch were to take your income, which would never happen, then I would understand why you would complain. You're upset about how some people perceive you? Is that really an issue worth complaining about? And like I said, this isn't even true. I would even argue that male streamers have it harder on Twitch because the staff favors women. Sorry, attractive women. You don't want to get a BJ from Behemoth Betty, I understand. Are there fans out there who are like, oh, this woman made one mistake, screw her? Yeah, of course. But what's really more of a prevalent issue? A small group of biased kids, or the heads of the platform abusing their power? You live a pretty comfortable life. I don't even know why you're complaining about this, because clearly it has not affected you. You're making thousands, sitting on your fat ass, doing nothing. Why should I care about a small group of people not wanting to watch you because you make one mistake? It sucks because I can understand why guys have an easier time relating to guys and girls to girls. So if a community is male dominated, there's bound to be biases. Well, you better count yourself lucky that the industry is male dominated, because if it wasn't, you wouldn't have a fucking audience. Also, she provides no examples. I can think of one. Dr. Disrespect. Yes, he lost his platform recently, but after he cheated on his wife, he still had an audience. The issue with this argument, though, is that she doesn't provide an example of how this privilege doesn't apply to women as well. Alinity f***ing Chris Browns her cats, and people still watch her. She's also admitted to marrying a guy just for a green card and then divorcing his ass later on. By your logic, she shouldn't have an audience anymore. Hell, this stupid logic doesn't even apply to you. How come you still have a relatively strong audience after the whole Bo Blacks incident? The majority of your audience watches you because you're attractive. Do you really think they give a shit when you act like a vile human being? Your audience consists of boys, lotion, and a box of tissues. But I hope that in this day and age, we can learn to be both fair and empathetic with others regardless of this. No, you don't. If that were true and Twitch put you on the same grounds as male streamers regarding their garbage policies, you would frequently be suspended. The rest of her tweets consist of her saying pretty generic and bland positive statements. You know, shit you'd hear from your first grade teachers. Good vibes only. That's why I created a second account to start Twitter beef. Pokimane is friends with iDubbbz' girlfriend. Pokimane might call herself thick, but she has the thinnest of skins. She is horrible at taking criticism. She's a fat pussy. For example, this is her reaction towards some random kid, a kid, talking about how sexy she is.
By the way, can I just say I'm baffled at the fact that the clip of him saying he beats his meat to me, Omegalol, has 13,000 upvotes!
Oh my god, this random kid said he wants to beat his meat to me. Oh, that's so horrible.
I mean, that's why people watch you. I don't know why you're so surprised. At least that kid's being honest. Because Pokimane got butthurt, the very young child made an apology video talking about his very harmless dumb joke.
Hello, YouTube. This is Toxic. I was in Pokimane's game recently, and there was some negative energy.
There was some negative energy. Is that what you call it when you say shitty things to someone, okay?
This kid sounds like he's 4 years old, and she's trying to make this into a serious situation. You know, she's probably mad because that kid is basically exposing the reason why people watch her videos.
And so I just wanted to come out and say I'm sorry about all the inappropriate things. It was meant as a joke, a big joke. And
should I drop the 100 bomb peeps?
Offensively, and so
up to you.
I just wanted to say that I'm sorry for it, and this is my YouTube channel. Anybody else claiming to be me on Instagram?
That's the part that gets me. Really sorry, by the way. Also, make sure to sub, like, and comment. Anybody else that is pretending me, not me. I definitely am really sorry for what I did, and I don't want any exposure for it, but, like, sub to my channel. Turn on notifs. Make sure to hit that bell button, guys. Leave a comment saying, like, what kind of videos you want me to do.
Stupid kid. That's not genuine, you stupid f***ing 4 year old. This kid's so dumb. Why are you taking this so seriously? I just don't get how someone doesn't see this and just laugh it off or ignore it. It's a fifth grader, who cares?
You know, I don't even want to like mess with this kind of stuff because these kids are so young. Like, he shouldn't be saying things that are inappropriate. He also shouldn't be under this much, like, attention.
Yeah, and I can see you're definitely following through on that statement by exposing him on your platform for tens of thousands to see.
People write these kind of comments thinking that, like, the person they're writing it about will never read them. They are so open and perverted because of, like, the, you know, the cover of anonymity. Sorry if I'm mispronouncing ESL forever. Anyways, big E girl, she does a good job at covering it. She mastered the opposite of titty streaming by pretending to not show her butt every time. Dude!
I have a hard time believing you're this oblivious. You're pretending to be surprised because you don't want people to believe that your audience just watches you for eye candy. You don't have a personality, so I don't know why you're so shocked about these comments. Your audience is merely telling you why they watch you. I'm sorry, but it's true.
Do you guys want me to like surgically remove the bottom half of my body? I don't know what to do at this point. I don't know what to do. I'm about to like stop, drop, I'm gonna like hop into my bed, flop over this way, and then run over to the other side. Like, I don't comprehend.
Well, an easy solution for that is to turn on your uwu sexy kawaii wallpaper while you walk out of your chair. That way, people won't see your ass. But you don't want to do that because you want people to see your ass. So for you to get this butthurt over something you're fully aware of is pretty funny.
And I can't imagine someone sitting there and be like, and like being proud to write in this comment section. I am proud that I used her to clickbait children and make money.
Yeah, what kind of person would want to clickbait children? In conclusion, she kind of sucks. Like, I admire her in a way for being able to make money for basically just sitting in a chair, but she's so damn fake. But anyways, buying stuff.